juice that is?
Yeah, just kind of right in the side, flanking.
Well, I should have sent my CNW because it's you didn't call us. Well,
my water out.
Okay. Oh, anyway, take your water.
Okay. That's okay.
Okay, I think we're ready to proceed here, get underway, if that would be okay, and we'll proceed. Thank you for being here. We appreciate the media that are watching in from the bank cameras elsewhere as well. Unfortunately, many Canadian families experience the breakup of a marriage, and when this happens, the results can be devastating for children. Children are caught in the middle, but should not be used as a weapon or alienated from one of the parents. Aside from proven abuse or neglect, Canadians do want equal shared parenting to be the presumption in our courts when marriages break up, because it really is in the best interest of children, and it's also part of an enlightened equality agenda. Liberal leader Michael Ignatieff has written, these groups demanded that the custody and access regime created by the Divorce Act of 1985 be replaced with a shared parent regime in which both parents are given equal rights to bring up their children. These are sensible and overdue suggestions, he says. And the fact that they are being made shows that men and women are struggling to correct the current, to correct the rights revolution so that equality works for everyone. Bill C-42, as it's numbered, would direct the courts to make equal shared parenting the presumptive arrangement in the best interest of the child, except in proven cases of abuse or neglect. This bill is very important in bringing Canadian legislation into line with what the best research says about the best interests of children. With limited exceptions, children generally demonstrate superior outcomes when both parents, mom and dad, are actively involved in their children's lives, even if the parents divorce or separate. This bill reflects the spirit of recommendations made over 10 years ago in a joint House-Senate committee presented to Parliament entitled For the Sake of the Children. A recent poll conducted by Nanos Research, shows that 78% of Canadians support equal shared parenting, with a high of 86% support in the province of Quebec. Slightly more women than men support equal shared parenting. Among supporters of major political parties, about 78% of Conservatives support equal shared parenting, 75.8% of the NDP, 80.6% of Liberals supported equal shared parenting, and this is those who claim to support the Bloc Québécois, a high of 83% of Bloc supporters endorsed equal shared parenting. I'm grateful today for the many expressions of support from parliamentarians on a multi-party basis. I'm thankful that two of my colleagues are here today, Liberal MP Raymond Folco and Stephen Blaney, both representing Quebec ridings.
He's just
conservative. Did I say that? Liberal MP Raymond Folco and
nobody's
conservative.
He wants to be, but he's not yet.
And Stephen Blaney.
I was talking for you.
both representing Quebec ridings, and I'm grateful that colleagues on a political, nonpartisan basis can be here today. And they're on the platform to speak and provide you that French perspective on this widely supported initiative in La Belle Province. Countries such as Denmark, Belgium, and Norway, as well as some U.S. states, have implemented equal parenting, joint custody, or shared parenting presumptive legislation, resulting in lowered court costs, less conflict, and improved social outcomes for the children of divorce. In the few years that I've been dealing with this issue, I've heard from so many men and women who have urged me to pursue these reforms. And in the just past 24 hours since introducing this bill, I've received an outpouring of thanks from across the country, emails. I've got a whole reef of them here. I was at points yesterday almost a basket case as I was reading these heartfelt expressions of thanks from people across the country. Many of these people have been and will be working with their members of parliament as well as with provincial politicians to build a strong nonpartisan foundation for lasting equal shared parenting reforms that will be in the best interests of Canadian children. Equal shared parenting is the right thing to do for Canadian children. And as Liberal leader Michael Ignatieff has said, these are sensible and overdue suggestions. And the fact they're being made shows that men and women are struggling to correct the rights revolution so that equality works for everyone. This bill is one of the most apolitical, nonpartisan pieces of legislation introduced in this current parliament, and I look forward to strong support for this important piece of legislation from all members of parliament who are committed to the best interests of our Canadian children. I'm going to turn it over to, at this point, Kristen Titus, who is the co-president of the Canadian Equal Parenting Council. That's an umbrella group for more than 40 organizations across the country, so she speaks on their behalf in a general fashion. Then we'll move to John Manier, who is the barrister and solicitor and founding member of the Canadian Equal Parenting Counseling Council. And then we'll go to Lise Bilodeau from Quebec, and then my friend Ramon Folco, and then lastly Stephen Blaney. So we'll proceed in that order, and then questions as you choose from there.